Hi, I'm Tom Sainsbury and I'm in Silo Park in front of this amazing huge man-made spider web with one of the scientific brains behind Bug Lab. This is Phil Servet. He's a real bug enthusiast. And would you say spiders would be one of your favourites of the oeuvre of smaller creatures?
They are my favourites, absolutely.
Great. Yeah. Can you tell us a bit about this web that we're in front of?
Well, that's your classic all-web spider. It's a design that's involved in several families. It's so good. It's a really good way to catch flying insects. You can see it's got that vertical plane. It's got that nice, efficient prey capture spiral. So here's a trick. If you're drawing a spider web, don't draw a whole bunch of circles. Draw a spiral starting in the middle and work your way out.
So is it something about the spiral design that helps with the strength?
Well, it's actually a nice simple way to lay it down. Rather than trying to work out where to put the next ring, you just simply go out a little bit.
Yeah, great.
And each thread, you'd go out a little bit more and you'll work your way around and make a nice easy thing. It's simplicity itself.
It's so incredible. Yeah. And it would be made out of what we would refer to as silk?
Yep, it's all silk, but there are different kinds of silk involved in different parts of web construction.
Oh, wow.
Well, see, a lot of insects and other animals use silk, but spiders are the true master weavers. Spiders are using it for the moment they're at the egg sac.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
right.
And they're using it for all sorts of jobs.
And could you liken it to anything like a mammal? Is it like a mucus? Is it like a...
It's effectively a chain of proteins, really. And when you extrude it from the spinneret and put it under tension and expose to the atmosphere and moisture in the atmosphere and things, all that chemical magic happens and it gets all those lovely mechanical properties that we associate with silk.
Would different spiders have different silks?
Absolutely, even between the sexes you can have. Within the same species you can have different silks.
Yeah.
I mean, a male spider does not need to make egg sac silk, for example.
Yeah. And so there's the orb web. What would be some examples of some other ones? Say, for example, the ones that live in little burrows and things. Do they use
web? Other webs, yeah. Absolutely. There's all sorts. There are trapdoor spiders, here the tunnel webs. Up here in Auckland you get the banded tunnel web, which is a rather handsome looking spider, and so it makes a tube-like web inside, inside the roots of trees or in the ground or whatever.
Yeah. And so would a creature be attracted to come into it and get
No. Effectively, again, it's got some threads out there, and if something walks over it, out they come. One of the things a web does is it's like a radar. It lets you know what's going on in the immediate environment. So a spider's really attuned to what's going on. In fact, the most insane example I can think of that people will know is the daddy longleg spider. They are incredibly aware of what's going on in their web. I saw a white-tailed spider. Now, white-tailed spiders specialise in going to the webs of other spiders and hunting them there. It took two steps onto a daddy longleg's web, no more. Silk is raining down from the daddy long legs, and inside 10 seconds flat, the white tail is being hauled up for lunch. It was incredible.
So do you think that are they sensing it by being,
they sense all the vibrations, and they can work out where something is in the web.
Just on a side note, if you want, there's this old wives' tale that daddy long legs are the most, have you heard this one, that they're the most poisonous?
Yeah, I've heard this
one. And that they don't have the mouth to bite. Is this completely false?
It's pretty false. Yeah. Even the Mythbusters have done this one.
Oh, they have?
They have. Right. You can see the film on YouTube, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But anyway, no, they have, for a long time it was actually thought they were one of the few spiders without venom glands, but they do have them and they're very tiny.
Yeah.
But, they also have a difficult time biting because their chelicerae, which is the structures that carry the fangs, are fused where they attach to the body there.
Yeah, right.
So they really can't open up the gate very much, but they can still bite. Mm. I know people who have been bitten.
Really?
Nothing happened to them.
Right. You can tell this.
Yeah. there's a variation on this that say they're only poisonous when they're fed on a white tail.
Oh, right.
Which is just not how it works. It just doesn't do that. No,
you don't
no.
consume so the super.
Yeah, pretty much. That's what people think, but it's just not true.
Yeah. Why are people scared of spiders, do you think?
I I used to be scared of them myself, actually. When I was four, a tunnel web crawled up my leg. And when you're four, it looks about the size of a tarantula. It covered my knee. I threw it off and squashed it with a rock. I don't think I could ordinarily have lifted.
Yeah.
But I grew out of it. I started watching spiders and was just amazed by their complicated behaviour.
Yeah. What allure and interest do spiders hold particularly to you? What do you like about spiders?
Well, not only are they amazing creatures in their own right, that have been around for a very long time, but in New Zealand we've got so many species that are only found here. And right now we're a little over 1,100 species and counting, and 95% of them are only found here. So they're as unique to New Zealand as kiwi, of tuatara, and all those other iconic things. They're found nowhere else on planet Earth. And some of these things are just found in one little corner of New Zealand and nowhere else on planet Earth. That to me is mind-blowing. I get the chance to find things that nobody else has seen before. That's what attracts me.